Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new video. On today's video, we're going to be talking about how to make an audio amplifier completely out of the parts from a spare TV like this one. So first thing you want to do is crack open the back of your TV. We'll probably take a Phillips head screwdriver or something, but we'll take a look. Once you have that done and all the screws are removed, carefully pop the back off the TV. Now, what you are looking at are the inner workings of the TV. There are a couple things that you want to be careful about. I'm sure you guys have heard of this if you've worked with TVs before, but there's a flyback transformer right here that leads up to the very top of the TV. There's might be a high voltage charge in this TV and you could get a good, decent shock, so I have an insulated screwdriver. What I'm just going to do is I'm going to pry it underneath like this and try to pop it out if I can. There we go, you see that? Now what you want to do is you want to take this and touch it to a grounded point, which would probably be the silver thing. I would touch it to that if you can. And, yeah, it's like we're all discharged and good. So that's done. Next, you want to pop this off the TV. This is the circuit board for the heating element in the tube here. And just try to get the board disconnected from the chassis down here. Do whatever you can, take off screws and whatnot. I'm going to do all that off camera for you guys, but then we'll come back, we'll have everything detached. Alright guys, well it took a little work, but I finally got the board off. And as you can see, this is the board with the flyback on it. I think that's important because there was a secondary board in here, but that had the power supply, so you want the one with the flyback on it. Okay, so now what you're going to look for is a certain type of chip. And we're not going to know what the chip is offhand, but we have some clues that help us get there. You're going to want to look for a chip that either starts with LA, KA, or TDA, and has between 5 and 20 pins. And I know that's a lot, but let me give you some tips here. Usually, it's not going to be one of these ICs right here. See how this is it's a flat chip IC? So I think they call it like a DIP IC. And it has like 20 pins. You want something that is vertical and not horizontally faced. So this one, for instance, is a good candidate. This chip right here looks to me like it's pretty good. Now here's why it looks good, okay? It's vertical. It has probably about 9 or 10 pins. I don't know if you can read that there, but it says TDA 2009A, so it's a TDA chip, and it has capacitors, electrolytic capacitors around it. Now, usually when something has these large value electrolytic capacitors around here, low voltage and high microfarads, like this is 1,000 microfarads, that is a great indicator that that is an audio filter capacitor. And if we actually look on the board, it says audio amp right here. So we guessed pretty much correct on our first try. So this is the audio amp chip. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to Google the data sheet, and I'm going to be able to determine, you know, how many watts it can output, what the circuit configuration is, what components I need, stuff like that. So let's do that right now. Alrighty guys, so here is the data sheet for the TDA 2009A that I looked up on alldatasheet.com. It's a great website, highly recommend it. As you can see, it's got high output power, and it's a 10 watt plus 10 watt stereo amplifier, so we got two channels. So that'll make for a special hi-fi sound. And the datasheet also says it takes 8 to 24 volts, which means that we can make this portable. So this chip is great for making an audio amp. So now let's focus on getting the chip off the board. So great, you found the chip, you know what components you need and whatnot. How do you get them off the board? One of these things will probably do the trick. This is just a standard benzomatic propane blowtorch, and works pretty well. Let's see if we can get this thing to light. Go. So what you do is you just grab it with your fingers and pull the bottom, and I'm going to say this is pretty long. So there we go. We have most of our components, and now we can go take a look at the circuit and figure out how we're going to build this thing.
I ended up Google image searching the TDA 2009 circuit, and I came up with this one from electcircuits.com. And this is a pretty good circuit. As you can see, most of the components are pretty common. They can be all found on the TV board, the same board that the TDA chip was found on, except for like the audio jack and whatnot, but everything else can be found there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to assemble the circuit on a prototyping board, and we'll go from there.
All right, guys, got a little pro tip for you. Now, if you have a vertical IC chip like this, what you want to do is instead of putting it in like this straight, as you can see, the pins aren't really going to fit. So what you want to do is you want to turn it in about a 45-degree angle, and that way the pins will fit right into the board that you're working with. All right, guys, as you can see, we got the finished setup here. Basically, this is the entire audio amplifier. I built it straight from parts off of the television. As you can see, our chip is right here, and we have some bunch of capacitors here, a couple resistors for decoupling and filtering and whatnot, and we're using a 12-volt lead-acid battery as a power supply. You could, of course, use lithium batteries or a wall wart or any type of battery. Even a 9-volt might work, depending on what your chip is. Now, this amplifier is supposed to be a 2-channel amplifier rated at 10 watts per channel. I am only hooked up one speaker, though, just to show you, just to give you a sample of what it sounds like. So what I'm going to do first is hook this up. You might hear some screeching. This phone outputs a slight screeching sound when there's no actual audio being output. So actually, why don't I start the audio? This is some music that me and my friends created, so it's royalty-free. Let me hook it up for you. There you go. It can get quite loud, as you can see. And if I add another channel, I have a stereo, 20 watt audio or 10 watt per channel audio amplifier. So once again, this is a great project for you people who like to tinker with stuff. And if you have an old TV lying around or something and you want some speakers, definitely grab that TV, dig into it, and see if you can find an audio amplifier integrated circuit chip that you can turn into your own personal audio amp. And that'll do it for today's video, guys. If you like this video, please subscribe and comment. I know I've been taking a huge break, but I'm going to really amp it up with the electronics videos and how-tos as I'm starting to find more and more projects that I really want to share. So thank you guys very much for watching.